Questions 1 through 3 refer to the following types of elements in the periodic table. A. Noble gases. B. Alkali metals. C. Halogens. D. Transition elements. E. Actinides. Question 1. Which of the following types of elements are the most difficult to oxidize? The answer is A, the noble gases. To answer this question, you need to know what the word oxidize means. It can mean to combine with oxygen, but more generally, it means an atom or molecule loses electrons, so it becomes positively charged. The elements that are the most difficult to oxidize, or reduce for that matter, are the noble gases. They're considered inert. Remember, the noble gases are found in column 18, group 18, on the far right of the periodic table. Question 2. Which elements are always radioactive? Okay, these are the actinides, which are found in that strip on the bottom of the periodic table. You may not have realized that all the actinides were radioactive, but you've probably heard of plutonium and uranium, which are used in bombs. There are lots of other applications using radioactive elements. For instance, americium is used in metal detectors. So yeah, the answer is E. Question 3. Which elements are most likely to form anions? Okay, so you need to know an anion is a negatively charged ion. So the question is asking which elements are most likely to accept an electron, one or more electrons, and become negatively charged. The group next to the noble gases, the halogens, group 17, can accept one electron and become anions. These are the elements like fluorine, chlorine, bromine. You know they accept electrons and become F-, Cl-, Br-, and so on. When they do, they achieve a noble gas electron configuration, and so then they're very stable. So the answer is C. You might be tempted by B, the alkali metals, which are in group 1, but those are most likely to form cations, positively charged ions. If they donate an electron and become cations, they also achieve noble gas electron configuration, but again, that's cations, not anions, so don't be fooled. Be sure to subscribe to Socratica so you don't miss our next video, which will cover questions 4 through 6 of the 2008 Chemistry AP. If you found this video helpful, please like it and share it with your friends. And if you're very happy with the videos we make at Socratica, we'd love it if you would consider becoming our patron on Patreon. By making a small donation every month, you'll be helping us make more high-quality educational videos for everyone to enjoy. Thank you.